Despite their obvious love for each other, the legendary union of DiMaggio and Monroe was controversial from almost the very beginning. Homespun boy that he was, Jolton Joe was pretty much looking for a stay-at-home girl, a fairly ludicrous proposition in the face of Marilyn's highly successful career. After the 54th season, the couple jetted off to the Far East on a joint promotional tour. As Monroe did her best to whip up the troops into a frenzy with her seductive performance, husband DiMaggio was instantly infuriated. Although he understood that here was a part of Marilyn that he was destined to share with the world, his simple heart just couldn't bear it, as we see here.
How have you and Mrs. DiMaggio enjoyed your trip to Japan?
Well, everything has been fine. We've enjoyed our trip. The only thing that I have to complain about is I haven't seen very much of Marilyn. She is making a trip to Korea, touring through the camps, and so maybe after that night we'll be able to spend a little time together.
Thousands of Japanese baseball fans jam Tokyo's Haneda Airport to welcome the United States All-Star Major League team. Joe DiMaggio, the Yankee Clipper, is one of the top attractions and makes a big hit with the Japanese fans. The 20-man American team, managed by Lefty O'Doul, will play a series of 15 exhibition games throughout Japan. The next day, the Americans open their Japanese season with a 7-0 victory over the Yomiuri Giants. The Yankee stars may win the Japanese World Series, too.
The American team takes the field, but first they pause for the shutter bugs. Here's Joe DiMaggio, pitcher Eddie Lopat, and manager Lefty O'Doul. Joe's kid brother Dom of the Red Sox DiMaggios. Eric Tipton, who caught for the Philadelphia Athletics. Fancy first sacker Ferris Fain, likewise of Philadelphia. The two opposing managers get the lowdown on ground rules from the umpires. Mrs. Ridgway throws out the first ball and the game gets underway. Takeshi Nomura delivers a fat one to Joe DiMaggio in the sixth, and Joe belts the horse hide into the stands for a home run, and the crowd loves it. Dom clouted a round tripper in the fourth, so Joe had to deliver to keep up the family slugging tradition. The Americans get six runs in the sixth to take a 10-0 lead over the home team. But the Nipponese Ball Hawks won't give up easily. Kawakami, the Mainichi cleanup man, smashes a single to load the bases with only one out. But Kawasaki hits into a double play, ending the threat and the game. The Americans drop the Orioles 11-0 to keep their victory string intact. The visiting Americans sharpen their batting eyes against Japan's top pitchers. What a way to get in shape for next season.
Unfortunately, as time went by, it became readily apparent that Joe and Marilyn just weren't going to make it. In October of 1954, Marilyn's attorney announced the sad news to an awaiting world.
Marilyn Monroe and Joe DiMaggio are presently having domestic difficulties. Miss Monroe has decided and authorized me to file an action for divorce.
Miss Marilyn Monroe and Joe DiMaggio are presently having differences in which they have brought about a separation. Miss Monroe has decided to file an action for divorce in Southern California, and it will be on the usual and ordinary grounds of mental cruelty. There will be no property or financial disputes between these parties. Both of them regret the necessity of the action, but they feel that it is inevitable at this time.
When, in 1962, Marilyn Monroe was found dead under mysterious circumstances, DiMaggio was quite frankly crushed. For 25 years thereafter, Joe made sure there were roses delivered to Marilyn's crypt in a Los Angeles cemetery every week. What follows is the official announcement of her sad passing.
One of the most famous stars in Hollywood history is dead at 36. Marilyn Monroe was found dead in bed, under circumstances that were in tragic contrast to her glamorous career as a comic talent.
Here, Bruce comments on Jodie's troubled love affair with Marilyn Monroe.
Well, I think we know very little about his relationship with Marilyn Monroe. They were only married for a year before they were divorced. He had refused for many years to talk about that relationship. It was something that he felt should be a private matter, and I don't think he really opened up to anybody, at least in the media, to talk about it. You know, the fact that he went out with this famous actress who was an icon in her own right and was a legendary figure in her own right, and then, of course, eventually they became married, I think that just kind of adds to this legendary, mythic-type figure that we remember Joe DiMaggio as. It's not that often that a star athlete is linked with, you know, an absolute Hollywood superstar. And you had, in that situation with Joe DiMaggio and Marilyn Monroe, you had one of the most famous players in baseball and then one of the most famous actresses in Hollywood. And that kind of a pairing, two people that are at that level, you know, that doesn't happen very often. So I think that does add to the mystique of Joe DiMaggio.